Well, good evening, everybody, and welcome to our annual celebration evening. Tonight, we're celebrating the achievement of undoubtedly the best house at Netherhall. Yes, Franklin House. Of course, we're living in very different times at the moment, and I'm sure none of us would have ever imagined that we'd be broadcasting into your home rather than meeting you in person. However, we were determined that nothing was going to stop us from celebrating the incredible achievements over the last year. Tonight, you'll hear about students' achievements in a range of spheres: academic, sporting, the arts, and much more. Crucially, though, achievement is not about coming first, nor is it about being the best, getting the highest grade. It's about giving 100%, striving to reach your personal potential. Often, this involves placing yourselves outside of your comfort zone. And it means that you're more likely to experience failure. But in this sense, failure is a good thing. It tells you where you are now. It allows you to plan how to go further, and then how to go further again. We know that each of our students can achieve amazing things, and we're inspired by their efforts, their determination, and their optimism. Crucially, tonight we're looking back and celebrating what's been achieved in the last year. But we also want all of you to also look ahead, to be inspired, and to imagine what the next year will bring for you, and how you can be an inspiration to those around you. Over recent months, the whole Netherhall community has undoubtedly been inspiring. Despite all the challenges thrown at us, we have worked together to support each other. Students being prepared to learn in very different ways. Our staff being prepared to learn new ways how to teach, including the army of parents who've become honorary teachers for the last few months. We've been supporting our amazing key workers by keeping working throughout the holidays. Together, we've raised an amazing amount of money to provide 150 or more computer systems to our own students. And I know that we've all been keeping in touch with each other, boosting our spirits and looking after each other's well-being. Together, we've made a great team, and I want to take the opportunity to salute you all for everything that you've done for that. So now let's move on to the awards themselves.
Thank you for those words, Mr. Tooley. Now, obviously, we would have loved to have you here, as Mr. Tooley said, to join us in the atrium hall. However, it is just as good that we can come to you in your own houses and your own living rooms. We will be going through all of these awards tonight, and so hopefully your child's name can get read out. If not, then obviously we want to be able to read them out next year. So, just before we get to the awards, I'll hand you over to Shelley Monk, the Chair of our Governors here at Netherhall.
Good evening and welcome to this celebration event. I'm Shelley Monk, Chair of Governors. Congratulations to all the students receiving an award. You should be very proud of what you've achieved. Thank you for your hard work, talent and determination, which have led to your success. Thank you also to the staff at the school and your families for their guidance, expertise and support. I really like the poem Thinking by Walter D. Wintle, as it is such a positive message about the mindset for success. If you believe you can, you will. Thinking. If you think you are beaten, you are. If you think you dare not, you don't. If you like to win but you think you can't, it almost certainly won't. If you think you'll lose, you're lost, for out of the world we find. Success begins with a fellow's will, it's all in the state of mind. If you think you're outclassed, you are. If you've got to think high to rise, you've got to be sure of yourself before you can ever win a prize. Life's battles don't always go to the stronger or faster man. But sooner or later, the man who wins is the man who thinks he can. If we talk about Olympic athletes for a moment, research suggests that their ability to persevere and overcome setbacks helps them to achieve their goals. Some of the key messages in the research about what helps athletes to be successful could also apply in an education context. For example, using support available to you from other people, that could be family, teachers, or friends. Identify what's important to you. This will help keep you motivated and determined, especially when you do have a setback and your goals seem far away. View setbacks as opportunities for growth. Ask yourself what you've learned and what you would do differently next time. All we can ask of the students here at Netherhall is that you do your best. Think big and set high expectations for yourself. Learning can be messy, and if you don't succeed the first time, be kind to yourself, learn from it, and importantly, try again. As Aristotle said, we are what we repeatedly do. Excellence, then, is not an act but a habit. Congratulations once again. I hope to see lots of you back next year to celebrate your continued achievements.
Thank you very much, Shelley. So this evening, I've got the pleasure of introducing Mr. Carlson, who is the School Achievement Leader and Head of Franklin House.
Good evening. It's great to be here celebrating the achievements of Franklin. And we're going to start off with the attendance awards. Those students who have achieved excellent attendance throughout the year. Azan Asgar, Tristan Booth, Sienna Campbell, Sam Church, Tom Cotton, Ross DeVilt, Timo DeVilt, Zoe Herp, Finn Howarth, Kirsten Lim, Yo-Yi Liu, Georgina McHale, Jet Mitchelson, Kenley Nguyen, Joshua Papworth, Beth Perkins, Megan Rogers, Nikhil Rudin, Sweta Shibu, Shrilekshmi Shinu Nair, Nina Smith, Yanis Tsangalidis, Rajiv Verdi, and Charlotte Wilson. It shows real dedication and determination to come in every day, all year, so well done to all of you. Hopefully, next year, I'd like to read out an even longer list. Now, before the next awards, we have Rain Gascogne playing Yellow Brick Road.
When are you gonna come down?
Moving on to the Pride Awards. These accolades represent the Olympic values of personal excellence, respect and friendship, inspiration, determination and courage, and equality. These five aspects help to shape and guide our Netherhall students into the fine, upstanding individuals that we want in our community. These five values make up our Pride Pledge, and we want to recognise those who have demonstrated these to the highest level. We begin with personal excellence. This award goes to those students who have performed at an exceptional level throughout the year. Katie Clean, Bella Davis, Jem Collingwood, Freya Eyre, Emma Rizzardo, Asa Day, Roxanne Monuel, Miriam Vassell. And now we have the awards for respect and friendship. These students demonstrate excellent consideration and friendship to those around them, both staff and peers. Fionn Barnett, Yvette Owusu-Ansah, Alf Palo, Yanis Tsangalidis, Maya Trezais, Misha Lord, Alok Shah, Nate Perkins. Moving on to inspiration. All of these students have shown outstanding leadership skills, influencing those around them in a positive manner. Ross de Vilt, Seth Day, Jet Mitchelson, Tom Cotton, Rita Hack, Sam Livesey, Julia Tochiska, and William Bennett. The award for determination and courage goes to those students who have overcome obstacles to their learning this year and shown great commitment to their education. James Calder, Marcus Fenner, Kirsten Lim, Jake Ramsey, Curtis Rogers, Alex Edgley, Jade Mitchelson, and India Matthews. The final category in the Pride Awards is for equality. This is given to students who not only demonstrate an understanding, appreciation, and respect of the differences between students, cultures, and communities, but who actively do something to bring about positive change, either on an individual level or on a wider level. Philippa Ferreira, Natalie Church, Magnus Bramwell, Shulakshmi Shinu Nair, Essie Opie, Sweta Shibu, Akira Ferreira, and Timo de Vilt. Once again, huge congratulations to all the winners. You'll be able to collect your certificate and a pride stripe next year in school. Now, just before we move on with the next awards, a small snippet from the wonderful evening of dance.
Closing toast,
What a real highlight of the school year that was. And now I'd like to hand over to Jade Mitchelson, one of Franklin's house captains, to give us her reflection of the year that we've had so far.
Hello everyone, I'm Jade, the Key Stage 4 house captain for Franklin House, and I've had the privilege of being a house captain for 2 years and I've loved it. It truly has been one of the highlights of my year, and it's been great working with a team of teachers and students in a leadership role, and it's given me so many opportunities, such as assisting in the opening of the Miller Building, writing articles for the student newsletter and conducting student surveys to further the student voice. And now it's given me the opportunity to give one of the first virtual celebration evening speeches. So here goes. To say this year has been interesting would be an understatement, because I mean, we started with a bang. We had an amazing performance of Les Mis with students throwing themselves into the French Revolution, and then we had a nice relaxing Christmas break, and then came back in 2020 with flashing lights, with the ever popular evening of dance, and then the talent show showcasing yet again more examples of Netherhall talent. And then things started to quiet down again, and then we got to our normal routine. But little did we know that things were all about to change. So it's not an average situation. This event will go down in history, and I mean, we're making history. Even in this situation, as uncertain as it was at first, we have been able to achieve so much. We've all had to adapt to a new routine, and I may miss the structured environment of school. And I mean, it's so much easier to just, I mean, go and shut myself in my room and binge watch TV series and hoard a whole load of snacks and everything. But teachers have been able to show so much support and have had to adapt their teaching styles in various ways to help all students. And because of this, even with the imperfect conditions, students have been striving to submit detailed and high quality work. And throughout this, teachers have been giving their all, and this includes humouring us with the recording of the Break Free video, which brightened my day, and I'm sure it will brighten yours too if you haven't seen it yet already. Now, I mean, quarantine has been able to restrict us at whole new levels, but if it has shown me anything, it has shown me the perseverance we all have, how we have continued to complete work and attend live lessons. I mean, even many of us have taken part in the virtual arts festival and have had a go at house competitions posted on the student newsletter. I mean, we have all done so well in surpassing the expectation of doing nothing, and we have shown this strength in uncertainty. And even looking back, I mean, I may miss my old routine, but I do not regret adapting and changing for this new one. So, I mean, to sum up this year, what can I say? It's been a roller coaster. So, I mean, well done to all of us for being able to hold on for that last bump. Now, I wish you all well, stay safe, and enjoy the well-deserved break. Goodbye!
And now let's hear from the tutors and mentors of Franklin with the winners of their Form Class Award.
Hi there. The Form Tutor Prize for Franklin 1 goes to Tilly Lynn. She's been a great student, great help in form time. She actively takes part in all form activities, gets on really well with other students, and has really helped me out in putting up class displays. Thanks, Tilly. And just generally a very respectful, well-behaved, polite student overall. Brilliant.
The Form Tutor Prize for F2 goes to someone who is always polite and respectful. But in particular, this person is always very generous of his time and very generous of his talents and skills. For example, he stayed up extremely late one night baking cakes, especially for the F2 party. He arrived uncharacteristically late to form one day, and that was just because he had stopped to help out a fellow student who had fallen off their bike. And he's also spent a huge amount of time and effort in setting up and running the computing club here at school. So the prize for F2 goes to Yanis.
So well done to Magnus for winning this year's Form Tutor Prize for F3. We feel it's very much deserved. You're always very engaged in form. You give lots of brilliant ideas towards the quiz. And overall, I'd say it's your brilliant passion and understanding of respect and fairness to all the people of the world, but also to the environment and considering how we should look after it. And you share these ideas in a very mature and excellent way. And it's a credit to the forum that we have you there helping with our debates and considering issues that we discuss. You do very well. And I know that Ms. Girardi and I'm sure all of F3 would agree that this is a much deserved award to you. So well done, Magnus.
F4 this year goes to Parv Dhillon because he has been an absolute fantastic help all through the year. Ms. Pavlichuk and myself both agree that we think he has been a really, really exemplary member of the forum and a fantastic role model to his peers. So well done, Parv.
This student is a great asset to our tutor group F5. Her punctuality is faultless and her uniform and equipment is immaculate as ever. She's very organised, extremely hardworking and pushes herself to excel in almost every task, including form activities such as the quiz. She was always there to greet me in the morning with a beaming smile and she is a pleasure to teach also. I look forward to continuing to watch her grow over the upcoming years and expect nothing but great things. The Tutor Prize Award goes to Abigail Lopez.
Hello everyone! This year's F6 Tutor Prize goes to someone who is a great role model to others.
Always.
They always have excellent attendance, punctuality, uniform and equipment.
And always helps me out with any equipment check that needs doing.
They're responsible and can be relied upon to complete jobs in form.
And around school if anyone was to ask them.
They always enjoy participating in tutor activities, from class discussions to quizzes, from contributing to Christmas boxes to choose respect lessons.
And is always keen to talk staff into buying whatever it is we're selling for the tenor challenge. This person's definitely going to make a great salesperson.
They also get involved in lots of the extracurricular activities on offer here at Netherhall.
And this person is never shy to share some of their hidden talents with us in F6.
She is always cheery and chatty in form, and if she's not, we know that something must be wrong.
And she always manages to wake me up at 8:40 in the morning with her endless chat.
She's like a ray of sunshine, which provides a great atmosphere for starting every day, for which we are very grateful, even if sometimes we have to ask her to be quiet.
She really is a ray of sunshine, albeit a very noisy one. We're lucky to have her in F6.
So this year's F6 Tutor Prize goes to Kirsten Lim.
Round of applause.
This year's F7 Tutor Award goes to somebody within F7 who takes a very active role within our form time. They are always getting involved in our weekly quiz, our class discussions and our Choose Respect programme. This person demonstrates himself consistently as a role model student. Their punctuality, their uniform is always exceptional. This person wants to make sure that everyone in F7 has a great day. They welcome you as you come through the door. They are somebody that if ever the mood in F7 seems a little bit low or everyone seems a little bit down, they will crack a joke, normally at my expense, but that is fine. They consistently go above and beyond to make sure that our form group is a very nice, happy, safe place. This year's F7 Tutor Award goes to Cassidy O'Hara.
Hello, my nomination for F8. Form Tutor Prize is William Bennett. He has been a fantastic member of the forum since I took over it whilst he was in year 8, but as we've continued with him now even being in year 10, he's just simply grown. He is a massive support to the younger members in the forum and has really become a little bit of a mentor to some of those, particularly those in year 8 and year 7, who have been quite open when speaking to him, and he's always been very welcoming and supportive with anything that they might need to ask him, which is why I've nominated him as our Form Tutor Prize winner. He's also a massive help to me every single morning. He's always willing to do the register if I need him to. He helps with the quiz along with other students, and he's always really enthusiastic in getting involved in anything the form is completing, and particularly the challenges when they have to do with charity. So a massive role model, and a really welcome member of our form who always brightens my morning. So thank you, William, and I'm looking forward to seeing you again in form time soon. Thanks.
Hello everybody, I am the form tutor of F9. I miss you all, and I'm really looking forward to you all getting back in September so we can all be back together. So, we're doing the prize. In order to consider somebody for this prize, I had to think long and hard. I've got top students in F9. So I thought back to September to now, and one person has stood out. This person, when we're in form, I can rely on to step forward, to take the gauntlet, to rise to the challenge. She's my quiz master. And over lockdown, she is the one who's emailed me, we've had conversations. She's shown real maturity. So I am very privileged to say well done to Rada.
Thank you to the tutors for your warm thoughts and sentiments there. And now it's time for another musical number, this time from Mary Juan and Eliza Gregory playing Just the Two of Us. Now we move on to the academic prize winners. These are awarded to the highest academic achievers in the year. In year seven for Franklin, it was Samarth Ganagi. The overall winner was Celine Jespers from Davies. In year eight for Franklin, the winner was Zoe He. The overall winner was Chihiro Egawa from Hobbs. In year nine for Franklin, the winner was Emma Rizzardo. The overall winner, again, was from Hobbs and was Mary Juan. In year 10 for Franklin, the winner was Ben Cotton. And the overall winner was from Davis, and that was Alice Jespers. Many of the next winners showcased their skills in the recent Arts Festival. The Art Awards help us to recognise the effort and dedication that they have shown over the year. So the winners are, in Year 7 for Franklin, Philippa Ferreira, and the overall winner was Jenny Youngs from Hobbs. In Year 8 for Franklin, the winner was Freya Eyre, and the overall winner was Jojo Bentley from Soyinka. In Year 9, the winner for Franklin was Matilda Lynn. And the overall winner was Rain Gasconia from Hobbs. And in Year 10, the winner for Franklin was Jade Mitchelson. And the overall winner was from Davis, and that was Hannah Burrell. Now, the sporting calendar was sadly curtailed this year, with students unable to compete in their usual winter and summer sports. Now, hopefully, you have still been active at home during the lockdown. However, we are still able to recognise those who have excelled in the sports arena. This year, the sports awards go to the following. In Year 7, for Franklin, is Ross de Vilt. And Ross was also the overall winner for Year 7, so congratulations to Ross on that. In Year 8, the Franklin winner was Jake Ramsey, and the overall winner was Polly Titherley from Hobbs. In Year 9, the Franklin winner was Raida Hack, and the overall winner was from Soyinka, and that was Grace Winchester. And then in Year 10, keeping it in the family, we have Timo de Vilt for Franklin, and the overall winner was Leo Fox from Soyinka. The Sal Prize is awarded to a student in the house who has been an inspiration to those around them. This person sets a positive example in the way he interacts with others, in his application to schoolwork, and in his contributions to the school council. However, in Franklin, we have a number of students who fit that description. This person goes further. When you first meet him, he may seem a quiet and unassuming character, but that belies a steely resolve and determination as he campaigns for causes of social and environmental justice. In his commitment to inclusivity, this individual is truly inspirational. Therefore, the winner of the Franklin Sal Prize for 2020 is Marcus Bramwell. Now, each year, the Madej Cup is awarded to a student who has shown determination and courage in the face of adversity. They persevere and strive to succeed when faced with a difficult situation. The winner for 2020 is someone who has faced a large medical battle head-on and has come out the other side with real resolve and focus. Tenacious and dedicated, this student continues to display great application in all her learning. So I am pleased to announce that the recipient of the Madej Cup is Chloe Gratwick from Davis. The final award of the evening is the Dickinson Award, named after Anne Dickinson, who served the school faithfully for many years. This award goes to a Year 10 student who has epitomised the school values and continued to represent and serve Netherhall in all areas of their 4 years. This year, I am pleased to announce the joint winners are Rosie Wagner from Davis and Lawrence Jan from Hobbs. Congratulations and well done. We are blessed with many amazing students here at Netherhall. And as we have celebrated their many qualities and achievements, it is encouraging in these uncertain times to know the world is in good hands for the future. Once more, I would like to congratulate all of tonight's winners. There are many other students out there who only just missed out on an award. I hope this event will inspire you to maintain your efforts and to make sure that next year, you are also a recipient of one of these awards. And now, back to Mr. Smith.
Thank you, Mr. Carlson. So I would also like to offer my sincere congratulations to those people that have gone through and just won an award from Franklin. Well done and congratulations. Now, just to finish off the evening, I'd like to hand you back over to Mr. Tooley.
Well, what a wonderful evening we've had. We are so proud of all of our young people. And I know there are many more who haven't received an accolade this evening, but have also been doing amazing things, supporting each other and their families during the closure, developing their skills, and preparing for the year ahead. We are really looking forward to seeing you all in September. Until then, stay safe and stay well.